U.S. government shutdown would halt military operations, Defense Secretary Jim Mattis warns. U.S. Defense Secretary Jim Mattis has warned that a government shutdown would heavily impact military operations, including training, maintenance, and intelligence operations, as the Republicans failed to pass a federal spending bill through the Senate. The U.S. government had until midnight on Friday, 5 a.m. GMT, to reach a deal on federal spending. However, the deadline passed, forcing the U.S. government to shut down until an agreement is made. However, just hours before the deadline, Donald Trump's Republican Party failed to get the 60 votes it needed to pass the bill in the U.S. Senate. Jim Mattis said, "Our maintenance activities will pretty much shut down. Over 50%, altogether, of my civilian workforce will be furloughed. We do a lot of intelligence operations around the world and they cost money, those obviously would stop." However, the Defense Department said a shutdown would not impact the U.S. military's war in Afghanistan or its operations against Islamist militants in Iraq and Syria. Mr. Mattis is set to leave the U.S. this weekend for a trip to Indonesia and Vietnam. The Pentagon said in a statement that Mr. Mattis' trip to Asia would go ahead even in the case of a government shutdown because it was necessary for national security and foreign relations. The U.S. Congress has been racing against the clock to avoid a federal government shutdown before midnight deadline on Friday after a meeting between Donald Trump and Democratic Senate leader Chuck Schumer failed to produce a deal. Donald Trump wrote on Twitter, "However, excellent preliminary meeting in Oval with Chuck Schumer, working on solutions for security and our great military together with Mitch McConnell and Paul Ryan. Making progress. 4-week extension would be best." Trump invited Mr. Schumer to the White House for talks, but the Democrat did not have much to say to reporters upon his return to Capitol Hill. He said, "We had a long and detailed meeting, we discussed all of the major and outstanding issues. We made some progress, but we still have a good number of disagreements." Earlier, federal agencies were warned to prepare for partial government shutdowns throughout America. In the event of a shutdown, many federal agencies close and workers sent home. The Secretary of Defense warned that the biggest impact would be psychological. He said, "It's got a huge moral impact. How long can you keep good people around when something like this happens is always a question that has to hover in the back of my mind." During his comments, in which he outlined the Pentagon's new national defense strategy, Mr. Mattis discussed the damaging impact of federal spending caps. He said, "As hard as the last 16 years of war have been, no enemy in the field has done more to harm the readiness of the U.S. military than the combined impact of the Budget Control Act's defense spending caps, and 9 of the last 10 years operating under continuing resolutions, wasting copious amounts of precious taxpayer dollars. As I stand here this morning, watching the news off the Hill, we're on the verge of a government shutdown or, at best, yet another debilitating continuing resolution. We need Congress back in the driver's seat of budget decisions, not in the spectator's seat of the Budget Control Act's indiscriminate and automatic cuts." More than 800,000 federal employees were furloughed during the last U.S. government shutdown, which lasted more than 2 weeks in 2013. During the 2013 shutdown, the Internal Revenue Service furloughed 90% of workers, according to the Liberal Center for American Progress. Since 1976, the U.S. government has shut down 18 times.